Understanding the chemistry of an aquarium can be challenging, but it's not something to ignore. Testing and knowing the chemistry of your water paves a path for long-term success. Knowing aquarium chemistry is often the difference between a mediocre tank and an outstanding tank. It tells you when you have to do a water change, it tells you when you have to dose, it tells you many things that you normally wouldn't know. Testing the parameters of your aquarium gives you aquarium superpowers. It allows you to see upcoming problems before they strike disaster in your aquarium. The common parameters tested in an average tank include temperature, pH, mineral hardness, and nutrient levels. The temperature of common aquarium styles can be anywhere from 70 degrees to 80 degrees, with 78 degrees being ideal for a tropical tank. Remember to research the animals you plan to keep because they may prefer temperatures outside of this range. The target value for pH and water hardness vary depending on the style of tank you have and what animals are being kept in it. For example, discus prefer softer and more acidic water, while African cichlids prefer harder and more alkaline water. Saltwater tanks are also alkaline and mineral rich. In regards to nutrient levels, generally the total amount should be fairly low, if not zero. Ammonia and nitrites should be kept at 0 parts per million, and nitrate should be kept under 25 parts per million, with phosphate being kept under 1 part per million for a freshwater tank and under 0.02 part per million in a reef tank. Most invertebrates such as shrimp and corals can be sensitive towards higher nutrient levels, and unsightly growths like algae and cyanobacteria are more likely to occur. Depending on your tank, you may want to look at other parameters such as salinity, alkalinity, calcium, magnesium, potassium, and trace elements. Moving on, a common question that is debated in the aquarium hobby is whether tap water is okay to use in your aquarium. And the answer is, you have to be careful. The parameters of tap water can vary based on where you live and with the season. You should test it regularly and correct it if it's not ideal for the style of aquarium you are trying to keep. You must also make sure to neutralize any chloramines or chlorine that may be present in your tap water using a water conditioner. A lot of the time, tap water isn't appropriate and you should resort to other options like buying RODI water from your local fish store or making your own using an RODI unit. RODI, or reverse osmosis deionized water, has a TDS reading of 0, which makes it the best, most purest water to use in your aquarium. It can prevent you from introducing heavy metals, chlorine, chloramine, silicates, phosphates, nitrates, and other possible contaminants that might be hiding in your water source. All of this can also help prevent algae issues in your aquarium, along with getting the most color and behavior out of your inhabitants. One final note about house water softeners. The water produced by these systems are not suitable for aquarium use due to the high amounts of salts introduced into the water. Make sure you pull water from a faucet known to be connected directly to a municipal supply if you decide to use tap water. Aquarium chemistry is a fundamentally important topic for keeping aquatic animals in a healthy aquarium. Those who ignore this can end up with some serious problems that could have been prevented by using a test kit with some basic aquarium knowledge. Test your water, understand your chemistry, and enjoy your aquarium knowing every detail about it.